No. What is that? No, it can't be true. What? Is that what Jira looks like today? I've got a new software development project and our customers requested to run it in Jira with Kanban and I said, no problem. But I didn't use Jira for last 5 years and I've just opened it up and it looks so primitive, so simplistic. Is it even possible to set it up for professional software development process with Kanban? Okay, no panic. Anyway, I have no choice. I need to set it up the right way. Otherwise, it will be so embarrassing. My customers will think I'm an amateur. Will you help me? If you are new to this channel, here you can learn all aspects of project management that work in the real world. It's the right place for new and experienced project managers. Okay, right now most of the features are turned off. So first of all, let's review the project settings and see what features are available to us. So we need to go to project settings and then to the features section. You see, all IT project managers need to know how to use Jira. It's an industry standard for IT projects. That's why most jobs on the market explicitly require you to have experience with this tool. In any case, to run a software development project, I recommend that you turn on the following features. So first of all, the backlog, then the issue navigator, and we'll need releases. So let me explain it a bit. So the backlog is not actually a prescribed thing for Kanban, but I want to have it anyway. It will be our storage for all epics and tasks, and it will have a separate space that doesn't obstruct our Kanban board. Also, in the IT industry, we develop products in series of projects or series of releases. But we don't want to discard any idea that we cannot implement right now. Instead, we want to store these ideas for the next release. So Jira's backlog will help you organize your tickets by releases and features. Essentially, it's your way to manage project scope in an integrated manner. Okay, Issue Navigator will help you query and filter all the tickets on the project. Then you can export them, edit them in bulk, and create reports based on those filters. And I'll explain the release feature of Jira separately later in the video. It's a critical functionality that helps you with so many project management challenges, so don't miss it out. But right now, I'm moving to the second problem we need to fix with this Jira right now. So, you see, Jira on its own is dumb. It will do what you ask it to do. So, just using a Jira board doesn't automatically provide you with the benefits of the Kanban approach. So, instead, you need to know and implement prescribed processes and artifacts of Kanban inside Jira. So, let me ask you this. Do you want me to create an in-depth video on Kanban? If yes, pause the video now and write in the comments below. If I collect 30 comments, I'll make that video for you. So, the first prerequisite of Kanban is a board that visualizes our workflow. The crucial part here is to align your board setup with the processes you already have in the organization. As I have worked in my current organization for several years, I already know the development process we use here. However, if you just join your company, you must first discuss the process with your peers or assigned developers. Nevertheless, I will adjust our typical workflow, because in our previous conversation, I learned that clients don't pay for a business analyst. I'll be the one. Oh, by the way, here's some bad news for you. They don't want to pay for a business analyst for this project, so you'll need to handle it yourself.
Yeah, that's a bummer. We could not persuade them. Delana said she'll provide all the required information. Also, she said they want to do the project with Kanban because it works best in their organization. Do you see any problems here?
Well, with Kanban, no. No business analyst is a bigger problem for me. And you do remember that I have two other projects, so writing requirements will eat up a lot of my time. That's why I'll have to analyze the specifications they promised to provide and create tickets in Jira. So it becomes a critical step in this whole workflow. That's why actually I'll be a bottleneck in this whole process. And our board will look like this. I'll just add the business analysis as the first step. Okay, let me show you how to do it in Jira settings. But actually, we need to start with setting up statuses. And only then we can map them to the columns on our board. So let's click on the menu and manage workflows button. So here I will quickly drag and drop these statuses and name them accordingly. Then I can also specify some transitions. It's useful when a ticket can get into a status by a different logical path. I should give credits to Atlassian team. The UI here is very intuitive and you can easily deal with it without me. So I'll quickly put all these statuses on the board and after that I'll explain the setup. Okay, so from the backlog, tickets will get into the business analysis column. Then, after I finish writing out the acceptance criteria, it will go into the ready for development. Then, when someone is ready to take it for work, they will move it into the in development status. After peer code review and testing their own code, developers will move tickets into the in QA column. And when the testing is done, ticket will land in the done column. Moreover, tickets can't get into the done status without passing the in QA column. So only QA engineers have the authority to sign off a ticket as done. On the other hand, we may decide that we won't do a ticket. So that is why I've added the won't do status. And there is no restrictions on this transition. Now we need to map these statuses to the columns, which finalizes our workflow setup. Again, it's quite straightforward. You can't mess this up. Just don't forget to move the columns around. If you watched this video so far, it's a great moment to hit the like button. Do it right now because it will help me reach more project managers who need this information. Okay. Here's the next problem. Kanban has only 3 prescribed artifacts, and you must implement all 3 of them to ensure that Kanban and Jira provide a performance boost to your team. The first prescribed artifact is the board, and we have set it up already. But the second critical thing about Kanban is the work in progress limit. So let's set up the work in progress limits. All we need to do is to go to the board settings again. The idea is that you don't want to spread your attention on too many things at the same time. Instead, you want to focus your team on getting things done. In the long run, your goal is to play around these limits and empirically identify WIPs that provide the best flow of tasks through this process. Initially, I'll set the WIPs based on my gut feelings. So I'll limit the business analysis to 3 tickets. And obviously, I won't set any limits on the ready for development column. Then I'll set the in development to 2, because we have 2 developers. And I'll set the in QA column to 2 as well, even though we have only 1 QA engineer. The idea behind these work in progress limits is simple. At some point, your board will fill up. For example, you'll have 2 tickets in development and 2 tickets in the in QA column. Imagine that a developer finishes a task and wants to move it to the in QA column, but we are already at the WIP limit, so we cannot do that. Instead, you need to do everything possible to remove this roadblock. First, you ask people to focus on testing tickets in the in QA column to move it out of the way. Second, on daily basis, your team should focus on eliminating such bottlenecks where tickets are stuck or pile up for far too long in one status. It's the essence of the Kanban approach. Okay, but now I see another annoying issue that we need to fix right away. First, we need an additional level of organization to control the project scope. And second, we want to group tickets by stakeholder requirements. And that's why we need epics. But by default, epics are hidden from the backlog and you need to go to each separate task to link a task to an epic. That's why we need to go to the backlog and click the epic dropdown and turn on the epic panel. As a result, your epics will appear in a separate sidebar. And now you can easily link your tasks to epics by drag and drop into this sidebar. Oh, by the way, in the previous video we created a project chart and we have outlined some stakeholders' requirements. So let's fill out our backlog with these epics. I like to organize features in the backlog as user will experience them in current release. So for example, the first one is the login screen. And next the NFR, which is a non-functional requirement, integration with user database. Then fighting calculator screen and explosion calculator screen. Then we'll have the settings screen and another NFR subscription integration. In most cases, it is expected that you create epics and structure the project scope. However, you need to include your team in the breakdown of these epics into actual tasks. And here's another practical tip for you. You want to treat your epics as deliverables. And if you are not familiar with this term, I strongly recommend watching my video on work breakdown structure. I'll leave you a link in the description. Oh, and one more thing about epics. Don't create epics that span across multiple releases of the application. It will make a mess out of your backlog. Instead, break them into smaller pieces and group similar functionalities, for example, with labels. Overall, it will help you track the work you finished and prove that you met project's objectives. As you noticed, you can rapidly create tickets in backlog without filling out all the other fields. Likewise, you can easily link tickets to epics here, just drag and drop tasks on epics. Again, here's an insight from the real world. You need to focus on just a few epics and get them done from start to finish. Otherwise, your project will become an uncontrollable mess where people have to multitask and switch attention between different features of your application. The next fix that we need to do in this Jira is critical in software development. You can't efficiently manage a project without it. It's a version control functionality that is built in into Jira, but again, it was hidden at the start. But first, let me explain it for those who are not in the IT industry yet. So first, developers will write code to implement a feature of our application. Then they will create a build or an interim version of our app to test those new features and fixes of defects. At some point, we'll install this build on a real iOS device and perform some testing. So, throughout the project, you want to keep track of what new code gets into the application, at least on the Jira tickets level. But in general, remember that in most cases, we incrementally add new functionality to our application with each new build. That's why let's go to the release section of Jira. Here you can create releases. Then you can go to backlog again and mark what tickets go into the release. And actually you have two options here. First, you can plan releases. In backlog, you can assign tickets to a release in advance. It will mean that once you implement all tickets in the release, then you'll create a new build for testing with all this functionality. Second option is to release everything that is currently in the done state. So you need to mark tickets with the next release or fix for version field and then release it. Oh, by the way, on an advanced level, you can link Jira with developers' tools like Jenkins and automate the whole process. So, for example, when you click the release button, Jira will automatically create a new version of your application, generate release notes, and send an email to your QA team to notify them that the build is ready. So, ask your developers about these capabilities, because on a long-term project, it may save hundreds of hours on routine tasks like that. Okay, let's move to the next correction we need to make in this basic version of Jira. I always recommend that we keep everything in one tool. That's why let's start storing our project documentation in Jira as well. So Confluence is a project's wiki. You can store all your documentation here. And it is directly integrated with Jira. So we can go to the project pages here, connect Jira with a new Confluence space, and for example, I'll save our approved project charter for quick access. Also, I can easily link to this document from any ticket if I need to refer to it in the comments, for example. Now, here's the biggest problem. Jira is just one tool in the overall project management approach. You need to understand how it works with other processes and tools. That's why I recommend that you watch this full project management tutorial next. Click the video now because I want to continue our conversation. See you there.